The year is 1923, and a Soviet-Swedish expedition has found a new type of dinosaur named Tanius sinensis, after Tanius Z. Shu, the researcher who found it, and sinensis coming from Sino, the Latin term for the Chinese people. Despite the discovery of this fossil over 100 years ago in China's Wangxi group, it's only recently been completely described.
So quickly as an aside, the Soviets actually did a lot of paleontology, and some of it's only really just coming out now because they did their research in Russian, whereas most Western researchers did their research in English. So there's a lot that's been lost to time, but essentially it's just a single language barrier that's preventing the research of a lot of these new fossils, or new to the Western Hemisphere fossils. So getting new data about these fossils that were found decades ago is actually incredibly useful, and there should be more research on this kind of thing coming out in the near future, as authors mention in this paper. So without any further ado, what did they find out about Tanius sinensis? The fossil is unfortunately not super complete, but it does have enough features to help show that it is its own genus, and not an animal that belongs to a genus that's already known from elsewhere in the world, or elsewhere in China even, known by more recent standards. The scapula has a strongly curved top edge, and the acromion process on the scapula points forwards and up, which is a unique feature. There's a number of other features on just the scapula, but on the fibula, an arm bone, there's also a club-like tip to it, and a smaller crest which is used for muscle attachment on the humerus. And so while some of these features are, you know, cool, but they're relatively small, there's a number of other features that suggest it was a non-hadrosaur hadrosauroid, meaning it's one of the closest relatives to the hadrosaurs without actually being one just yet. There were large spinous processes coming off of the vertebra, more pronounced than there are in the hadrosaurs, and a ridge of the hip bone behind the femur was actually smaller in hadrosaurs. The lowest end of the femur in tetrapods has two condyles, and these essentially articulate with different bones, meaning essentially that's where it helps to connect to the bones, and they can rub against each other without causing much damage. Within this animal, though, these two condyles expanded and actually fused into an arch. So essentially, it was like a hot pocket for the muscles and tendons that would have gone behind the knee and attached to the lower leg bones to help the knee flex. This is an adaptation that we see nowhere else in the fossil record, and it really goes to show how important it is to essentially get over political differences so that we can try and understand some of these older fossils that were found even decades ago. And while those features are really cool, that's still not all of them. And these ones aren't actually from the animal itself, but potentially from another animal. And that's because before it died and was fossilized, it may have been hunted, because there's a series of small marks on the caudal vertebra, or the tail vertebra, which are likely from a bite, probably from an early tyrannosaurid or tyrannosauroid. So something along the lineage that would lead to Tyrannosaurus rex, although we don't know exactly where that would be. Fortunately for this specimen of Tanius, though, those marks are healed, meaning although it was bitten, it did get away and grow to a larger size. So good for it. A little bit of a bummer for the Tyrannosaur, but that's life sometimes. Phylogenetically, it also groups with non-hadrosaur hadrosauroids, so animals that are very close to the hadrosaurs, but not quite there yet, as I've mentioned. So this is animals like Gilmorosaurus and Bactrosaurus. But Tanius shows up much closer to the modern day than either of those other two genera of dinosaurs. Instead, it shows up either in the very latest part of the second to last stage of the Cretaceous, or the very beginning of the last stage of the Cretaceous. And these are essentially subdivisions of the Cretaceous. This means the non-hadrosaur hadrosauroids like Tanius made it to at least the very, very late Cretaceous, if not the very end of the Cretaceous, at the extinction event. So there may be an entirely new clade of hadrosauroid-like animals to try and find. And these researchers have already committed to doing more research on the Wangxi group. So with any luck, we'll actually get a better idea of exactly what these animals were doing and how widely dispersed they may actually be.